SMART is the dual-purpose tunnel in Kuala Lumpur function as a flood mitigation tunnel and road tunnel. With 4 km of drivable tunnel between Salak Interchange and Kampung Pandan, SMART is an attempt to reduce the risk of flood and traffic congestion that hit Kuala Lumpur. And how efficient is a SMART, the tunnel, in solving the flood and the traffic issues in the middle of the metropolis? Let's take a drive on the underground tunnel and understand of how effective SMART solving two problems with one tube. SMART is the short for Stormwater Management and Road Tunnel. Hence, the SMART tunnel is tunnel. Kuala Lumpur is located between two rivers in a tropical climate. Tropical climate means a lot of rain, a lot means a lot. Located on the Klang River Basin, Kuala Lumpur receives around 2,200 to 2,700 mm of annual rainfall. In an ideal condition, the runoff will be absorbed by earth and the water moves underground. The abundant rainforest trees reduce the rain acceleration, reducing the risk of landslides and protect the soil. In a city where the trees and grass are replaced by concrete and tiles, reducing the water amount that is absorbed underground. Where does the rainwater need to go? In the history of the city, Kuala Lumpur has been hit by the several floods. The most severe floods happened twice in the city's history, in 1924 and 1971. In 1971, the city was hit with the worst flood since the independence in 1957, flooding the whole area on the low-lying ground. The Great Flood of 1971 not only impacted Kuala Lumpur, much of the areas on the west coast of the peninsula was inundated as well. According to this paper, if there is no proper flood mitigation plan, just as it is, Kuala Lumpur will be hit by another mega flood by 2007 or later. Therefore, water mitigation channels need to be built so that the extra runoff could bypass the city center. However, limited open land available in the middle of the dense city makes the construction of a water diversion canal impossible if not too expensive. At the end, tunnel has been chosen to be the water carrier instead of a canal, as tunnel can be built underneath the existing public roads, reducing the need of private land acquisition. A tunnel that could save the city the valuable space it has and save the city from the future devastating flood. In addition to the excessive water flows that cause flood, excessive vehicles on the road cause the traffic congestion. Ping, 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 ping. Limited space available on the ground means enlarging the road in the middle of the city is expensive and unpopular. SMART is the first dual function tunnel in the world that carries cars in addition to the flood water. Then why does the tunnel just not focus only on one purpose? With a cost of 1.9 billion ringgit, flood water alone gives no income to the operator, unlike the electricity or the clean water or underground rail transit, where the utility users, anyone who wants to use the service, can be charged with a fee. As such, SMART is partially fitted with road tunnel and charged the toll to repay the construction and maintenance costs. The huge sum of 1.9 billion ringgit construction cost is too expensive to spend on a water tunnel which might occasionally active only a few rainy days in a year. Therefore, a road tunnel was fitted into the central segment between Salak Interchange in the south and Jalan Tundraza in the north with a branch to Imbi. The branch to Imbi connect the tunnel with the Bukit Bintang area. The tunnel was built by Malaysian joint venture of MMC Gamuda Consortium with two rented tunnel boring machines or TBM rented from Germany. The project was led by Hungarian tunnel engineer Gustav Klados, who also supervised the Channel Tunnel project, linking Britain with France across the English Channel. Building tunnel under Kuala Lumpur is challenging due to fragile chalky soil that easily collapsed when a tunnel was dug underneath the city. I talk about the challenging soil underneath Kuala Lumpur that led to the construction of monorail in the late 1990s, where the building an elevated monorail is cheaper than building an underground rail system. The link for this video will be appeared. Need to dig. The tunnel operation costs sustained by the toll collection, which otherwise the operator need to depend for the annual government allocation. Any vehicle that pass through SMART pay a toll, currently 3 ringgit per way. The water diversion section was opened on January 2007, while the road tunnel section opened on June 2007. Let's see how a single tunnel can save the city from flood and traffic congestion. Smart starts at Berembang Retention Pond on the northeast and ends at Desa Retention Pond, where the excess water is released to Kerayong River. When the rain comes and there is excess water on the river Berembang Retaining Pond, hold the water before it will be diverted through Smart. There are four modes of Smart operation, which are: first mode, the road is open and no flood water is channeled. The first mode is activated during clear sunny days to allow Klang River keep flowing in the middle of the city. Second mode, number two, the road is open but the flood water start to be channeled on the lower level. When Berembang Detention Pond reach its maximum level, next mode is activated. Mode 3, the road closed and the preparation for full flood water diversion happen. And mode 4, the whole tunnel is used for flood water diversion only. And it takes about 48 hours for a cleanup operation before Smart is reopened to the traffic. The tunnel will be cleared out of traffic before closure, so there is no report of people stuck in the tunnel before the flood water is diverted into Smart. On 19th of December 2021, Smart has issued a press release that the tunnel operated in mode 4 for 22 hours to divert 5 million cubic meters of water. In normal mode 4, the diversion duration is only about 3 hours. Part of the city was inundated with the flood water on that day, but the worst has been avoided on that day. Okay, how about the traffic? Smart was built under heavily congested road of Jalan Tun Razak with numerous interchanges that cause heavy traffic. The 4km stretch of the tunnel reduced the driving time from Salak Interchange to Kampung Pandan from 15 minutes on the existing road to just 5 minutes. Smart is a useful underground bypass in the time of rush hour when the road on the ground level are severely congested. I have been driving on Kuala Lumpur Road for years and never experienced traffic congestion inside the tunnel of Smart. Just hope that the heavy rain that do not come that day. And you might be asking why you wish so. During the heavy rainfall, when Smart activated mode 4, the tunnel will be closed to the traffic. Thus, the traffic on the existing routes became worse. The official reason, Smart priority is as flood mitigating system, road tunnel second. And then has the traffic on the road above the Smart on the ground improved after its opening in the year 2007? Nope. The traffic situation is not improving, if it not worse. After the opening of Smart in 2007, more expressways has been opened in the vicinity of Smart alignment. Maju Expressway opened on December 2007, Sungai Besi Expressway Eastern Extension on December 2014, and the upcoming Setia Wangsa Pantai Expressway. These additional toll roads prove that just one more lane bro firstly go to underground and one more lane bro above the ground elevated did not solve the traffic issues that should be solved by Smart. The upcoming Setia Wangsa Pantai Expressway SPE that partially follows the alignment of Smart is a testimony that adding more lanes in the city is not solving the traffic issues. Nice try! Even after the completion of Smart, Kuala Lumpur is still hit with a flood after heavy rain. The reason is that Smart diverted excess water from the city centre and not in the other outlying parts of the city. There are a number of retention ponds across the city to reduce the risk of flooding, albeit not extensive or expensive as Smart. In 2021, Kuala Lumpur was hit with a flood so bad that the historic Merdeka Square that's supposed to be protected by Smart was flooded. Other parts of Kuala Lumpur was hit by the flood as well. Nevertheless, without Smart anyway, the flood situation could be worse and cause more damage on properties and lives. As a conclusion, Smart is an expensive flood mitigation project that saves the poshest areas and historic sites of the city, the part of Kuala Lumpur that is important to the economy. Do you think that Smart is smart enough to solve the flood and traffic congestion issues? You can comment down below. If you want to drive in Smart Tunnel, the entrance of the road tunnel is at Salak Selatan, Imbi dan Jalan Tun Razak. The tunnel only permits car for safety reasons. Motorcycles, bicycle and heavy vehicles are not allowed. The trip duration from one end to another is about 5 minutes. Thank you so much for watching. I hope we learned something new about Smart and how a single tunnel try to solve the flood and traffic issues in Kuala Lumpur. Thank you so much again for watching and see you in the next video.